Welcome everybody on this beautiful Sunday morning. It's a Miami Grand Prix F1 weekend. So it was a quali yesterday. It was going to be race today. There will be a lot to watch and we are in the racing mood. I haven't been racing for a long time. So today I'm coming back to La Festa Cavallino in Gran Turismo Sport on my way to complete the campaign mode. It's all Ferrari races. So Fuji Speedway, the next race, and the car I'm going to use is a Ferrari GTO from 84, which I have just purchased on a previous video. So let's try that beautiful Ferrari on this Japanese track. I'm curious what we're going to race. Definitely there will be some Enzos and LaFerraris because they're always there. It's a racetrack with a very, very long straight, so the advantage goes to the super fast, modern, technological marvels, but we'll be trying to compete with them. A quick look at the tires I have. I have Sport Soft. The car is tuned to N500 group, while N600, I believe, is recommended. So one below, traction control is off. I think we're ready to race. Hopefully that works. I haven't checked it actually. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, that works. Okay, let's race. I'm trying to sync with my gearbox with what console gives me, what game gives me. Now I have no idea when to stop braking. Better aerial than late. Okay, so this car doesn't have good brakes, so we'll try again. I just need to learn the first T1 braking point, because that's something new for me, that car. Wow, why do I have such a strange view? I don't know how to change it. Here we go, much better. Like every new car on a racetrack, I have to learn it first a little bit. I need to do a small change on my wheel setup because it's set up for Assetto Corsa at the moment. There we go, that should help me. Mainly with braking, it was set up for Assetto Corsa braking, so the load cell was much harder than it did for Gran Turismo. Now we probably see the power of that Enzo in front of me. Maybe not. Okay, that's interesting. The GTO is fast while tuned. I'll keep it on the second gear this time rather than the first one. What's going on there? I think that was the LaFerrari. Not keeping it on the track. Oh my gosh, what have I done? I'll be fair and coming safely back to the racetrack. So we are 2 laps in, 4 laps to go. 14 and a half seconds a gap to the first. He's still there on the right hand side. I need to leave you enough space just in case. Okay, he's behind. 4 seconds. Collapsing. Does this thing have a sixth gear? No, it doesn't. Shift there. Release the clutch too early. And the third gear did not trigger. LaFerrari is dancing around and my 84 GTO has to fight with something like that. I think he's on my left at the moment. I'm really surprised that the GTO has enough power to overtake Italian straight. Oh, that's the LaFerrari here. I will leave him some space. Here we go. I only have 5 gears, so that's the maximum I can pull here. No, don't go in front of me on braking. What a knob. Tires are squealing like crazy. Mm-hmm. final lap. Oh, that was too early. I actually lost quite a lot there on that straight and the braking to the LaFerrari, I guess. Car is sliding quite a lot, even on the fourth gear. And it's a win. I didn't expect a win at the first try with that car, but it wasn't too hard actually. I need to let my dog out because it's going crazy. Doesn't want to stay with me in the room where I'm playing. That's a nice bonus in cash. I need a lot of cash. I spent all my money. Spent all my money on a Ford and a few Ferraris. Okay, so that's one less to go. I think I have two more races, and I think I want to do them in two specific cars. So I've got Sardinia, which is a fantastic track, and we've got Tokyo Expressway. So Tokyo Expressway, I'll also go do in GTO, and Sardinia, I want to do in 512 BB. I don't want to use the modern cars. I want to use the old cars. It's too cool to not to use them. Okay, so let's try with this one. It's tuned to compete with those modern cars in that series. So the way it is at the moment should be more than enough. If I will perform, though the problem is I don't know the racetrack because it's not a real track. So there will be some learning involved in that. Okay, let's race. Well, maybe it'll be just enough to remind myself. I think I know that racetrack, okay, that's good. That was in dailies recently. So yeah, I should be good. Obviously the braking points will be different than with the GT4 cars in the dailies. That car sounds quite nicely. Very low sound. Almost not like Ferrari. Seconds gap to the first one. Not sure how I'm supposed to reduce that in just 6 laps. Oh my gosh! I had a mistake there. Luckily it didn't hit the wall or the other car. He was driving here way slower than I expected. And now he's all over the truck. Between the F40 and the wall. just barely. Cool, 24 seconds, well 25 to be fair. I better start braking a bit earlier. I'm really not sure what are the capabilities of that car. Don't want to take any unnecessary risk. Finish gravel drop. Of course you had to hit me. And he hit me again, and I mean a different guy, but what I mean by again is saying that AI, I love how AI ignores the position of a player's car. I don't have LaFerrari to test it, but I can't believe it drives so badly that AI is struggling with that particular car so much. I don't know what's wrong with the driving algorithm for that particular Ferrari. Seconds, I'm P3. We have around 4 laps to do. And have two more cars to catch. A Spaniard and a German. Though as we know, catching is a completely different thing to overtaking. So let's see how it goes. slide in the left hander. I was a bit afraid that it will go to the sand. But luckily stayed on track. Watch the grass there on the right hand side, just between the road and the wall. Whoa, that's a big slide. That's quite... I wasn't even braking there. I completely lost it here. I wasn't driving on a full throttle. I wasn't braking, it just went sliding in the corner by itself. I lost concentration for just a moment while talking, and that was enough for that car to bite back. So I think this is Enzo, right? It's definitely not LaFerrari, so yeah, it's Enzo. And two laps to go. I'm sorry, mate. Oh, that was really ugly. I'm going to repeat that whole race. That was super ugly. Fourth gear. Let's go. Fifth gear. That's all we have. F4 in front. F4 on the left hand side and F4 behind me. So what do you fear? Italia? And I really don't remember what that Ferrari in front is. I'm glad I was able to overtake it before the turn. So another Italia there, I think. White one this time. I'm braking a little bit earlier. That's actually Enzo. I'm braking a little bit earlier for now, just to do it safely, not to hit anyone. Actually, I don't know how they're going to behave in some of the storms, like they were braking here, I didn't expect that. And he was really slow in that left-hander. And now he's going... So he went to the left-hand side, like he tried to, I don't know, prepare an attack for that F40. He failed. Side too wide in that corner. No, I'm in front now, but I don't want to hit that F40, so I have to keep it okay, steady and carefully. Here we go. 512, that's the same car I have. Earlier braking, I didn't have to brake so early, but again, I want to be careful considering the car, those cars in front. Is it GTO? I think it is. Still there on the left. Okay, now I'm in front. That's good. And then we have Enzo and... Is it 250? I think it may be. Oh, that was nice. Enzo on the right, I'm on the left. Well, I won't be trying to overtake him here. That wouldn't be wise, probably would be a crash. But I will try to have a better exit out of that corner. It's too wide. I'll make sure to leave him enough space. Here we go, and he's behind. Oh wow. Release the clutch too early. F50. I still don't have it. I need to save some money to actually earn it, to buy it. I'm not sure if I will have a chance to use it because I only have one more Ferrari race left after this one, and I'm going to use the GTO there. Because why not do? That's LaFerrari, which is really, really slow in corners for whatever the reason, but super, super fast and straight. Here we go. Now, that braking point. They tend to brake it really, really early, so I have to be very careful not to hit anyone. I'll try to get in the inside. Yes, I made it. And we passed all three of them. A bit of drifting there. Not intentional though. 15 seconds to the first one. I'm on P3. Close to that wall. Are really, really slight on the soft sports tires. And it would be much easier to control it with my left foot on the brake pedal, but because I'm using clutch, unfortunately, I have to do the braking with the right foot. I can use left foot in situations like that, where I can just, where I don't have to change the gear. 7.3 seconds. That's my fastest lap. That's Italia, 458. That was enough space there. Let's do it on the inside to this corner. Or maybe not. Oh, such a mistake. Luckily it wasn't serious and I recovered pretty quickly. But that's going to cost me my clean race bonus, unfortunately. Chasing P1 at the moment, which I think is Enzo. Laps to go, below 1 second gap to the first one. Didn't do the same mistake as on the previous lap. And I'm on P1. Let's see if the catch-up mechanism is going to switch on now, and if AI will start driving faster now when it's in second. What was that? I messed up the gearing here a little bit. Seconds, advantage over second, another fastest lap. That was a bit crazy, I was so close to that sand trap. Oh, so AI started driving much, much quicker than previously. 151, that's 3 seconds quicker than my best time. And they were slower till I wasn't first. So the catch-up mechanism is definitely on at the moment. Stop the car this time. Or I should have simply slowed it down to the speed required to negotiate that corner. So I'm still. Oh, that's a huge, huge slide in a most. In the worst possible moment ever. Those are the last corners. I need to be on the defense now. I don't know what happened there, to be honest. I completely lost that car. So unpredictable. But I managed to finish first. Ooh. That was very, very risky. I need a drink. Enzo, Italia, Enzo. Where's the first LaFerrari? 6 and 7 are 2 LaFerraris. That is a not good advertisement for LaFerrari, to be honest. Losing with so much older cars. Cool, so that was last but one race in that group. And now we have... Tokyo Expressway, such a boring track. And that I want to do in GTO, because I only drove that car once, so I want to drive it second time. Before I put it away forever. Okay. So I won't be changing anything. We're just going to drive as it is. It's estimated. So, yeah, they're saying cut the base. Advisable group is in 600 miles and 500, which is additional 20% bonus, which I'll take. Thank you very much. Fourth gear. Yeah, fourth gear should be good to start with. Fifth gear. But on this. 5 beats. Oh, it's raining. Okay, that's something I didn't know. Do they have... Well, if it's raining, If it is raining, I want to have different tires, right? Because it is raining. So I cannot have different tires. So I can only take sport soft, even though it's raining. Cool. I rather prefer some rain tires, but I guess they are classified as a racing tires, right? And because they're racing tires, switch off those wipers. This game is sometimes so annoying. Okay. So, sports tires on wet, not much I can do here. I don't have 6 gears, so that's the maximum I can do. I haven't done a lot of wet racings in Gran Turismo. Board. I did a lot in Project Cars 2 and Project Cars 1. I don't really know what to expect from the car on the wet here, like... Whoa! Something bounced me there really, really strong. Doesn't help that I don't remember that truck as well. Okay, so I reminded myself the truck a little bit, that was really ugly start, so I would give it another try. Fifth gear, that's the maximum. I was really, really late on brakes here. And those are wet conditions. On sports tire, I couldn't take wet tires. I really didn't know if I would be able to stop there. That was too fast. Many crushes, don't like it really. And here we go. Let's switch off those wipers for now. That's a wet race on sports tires. I checked, I couldn't take intermediates or wet or whatever type of tires there are. Oh, this one's driving quite slow. Okay, surprisingly I stopped here in time and I overtook a few at one go. Gap to first one is actually quite small, just 14 seconds. push me, man. Stay on your line. That was close. Whoa, and he pushed me straight to the wall. What an idiot. I had the clutch press, but not all the way to the end, and it wasn't enough, actually. I know it's wet, but it's super slow here. Oh, now I know why. That was quite a kick on that second gear. I didn't see that coming. Almost. Okay, that was quite good actually in that braking zone. Did it stop raining? Ah, it is raining. It's not strong rain though. It's quite wet. Though it doesn't feel like it's wet, to be honest. That game doesn't simulate wet too well. It's more of a visual effect than... Yes, I'm on your right hand side. I would appreciate if you wouldn't crash into me. Completely lost it in this corner. I made a big mistake here on the previous lap. Well, maybe it wasn't super huge, but that's LaFerrari on straight. Okay, that's another LaFerrari on straight. It's going to be hard to overtake those two on the straights. Cannot overtake, what is it, Italia, 458. Now I don't want to crash into them, so I'll be braking a bit earlier here. Then I don't want to crash into them, and he drove just in front of me. horribly. But to be fair, AI wasn't leaving me a lot of space there. They're very pushy. Completely ignore my line of driving. Like this one, now he was blocking me just because that was his programmed line of driving. Line of driving. Yeah, he will breathe next to me. No, he pushed me because there was not enough space on the right hand side, right? What an idiot. I don't care, he can push me if he wants to. But I will leave him enough space. Five laps, not six, like on the previous races. That's actually quite good. Really? I didn't... Okay. Fair enough. I have to admit, I was a bit surprised here. I didn't slow down in time to negotiate that left-hander, right-hander chicane. I guess it's slower than I remembered. Final lap, and I'm not sure if I crossed it on the first or on the second place. But that just shows the advantage of the LaFerrari in the straight. Wow, where this one came from? Okay, that's... It didn't stop in time. Really messy braking, really messy. Not happy with my driving on this race. To get some distance between myself and them or I'll be in trouble. I only have 1.6 seconds, which is not enough. Not in the car I'm driving. and I messed up gearing in such a critical moment. I think I'll have to be blocking. Nothing I can do. Not on that straight. This is the only track the LaFerraris are really, really excelling. I take it just for the money and experience, and then I'll try again the same car. I think it's doable. But I messed up badly, especially in the late stages of the race. So I'll humbly take the loss, and then I'll try again. Horrible driving, I don't know why even, but I'm refusing to take a faster car than this one. Bloody hell. Horrible, horrible, horrible. Oh my gosh, the hardest race of all. Fun enough, the race on the... Yes, I remember. The race on the most boring track of all used to be the most difficult, at least the car I picked for the race. I'll take the gap if there is a gap. That cart dances all over the road. I was a little bit pushy here, but I was leaving a big gap there. F50. Still don't have that car. left just to go bounce back to right. I didn't see it coming. Ugly move, really ugly move. And a spin. Oh, bloody hell. Oh. I'm tired of that race now. I really am. This thing is giving me headache. Interestingly enough, I overtook those two fast cars, and now the third one, but that was much slower than me. What a slide. At least I kept it out of the walls. Not this time. I was just a small one though. Nicely done. Not much space here. Okay, they left a big gap here for me, thank you. That's La Ferrari. That acceleration, unbeatable. Oh, I'm third already, okay, so there are two more to go. There's another LaFerrari and Italia. Not sure what he did there. I think he lost a bit of control over his car. And he hit me. Okay, I didn't expect to get to the first place so quickly. That's lap two. Flies like crazy. Okay, so I crossed the finish line on the first one on the second lap, but yeah, I don't have any chances whatsoever on straight. And that straight is quite long from the last turn to the start finish line. It may be really hard to keep the first place. That's how I lost it on the previous try. Why didn't turn? I wasn't driving. Okay, doesn't matter. Really surprises me. I have a feeling that the car behavior and weight is not consistent. Well, maybe that is just because I didn't drive enough in wet in that game. Like I did a lot of wet driving in Sims, but not in Gran Turismo Sport. I gained quite a lot in the last corner. I have a hefty advantage all the way to the finish line, which is a surprise. It is coming. They probably will overtake me before the braking zone. Maybe not. It's just right here on the left, yeah. But it wasn't very significant. I think I was expecting a bit more from that LaFerrari behind me. I need to focus now on increasing the gap as much as possible. And it's just 1.4 seconds, it's not growing. It was really easy to catch up with those cars, those LaFerraris, but then, once I got to the first place, it's really hard to leave them behind. Which is really, really annoying, because this is a very inconsistent behavior from this game. Seconds at the exit of the last turn. If I would have that on the final lap, which will start in just a moment, then I'll be really, really happy. Because that's just enough to achieve that start finish line on the P1. That car is fast, bloody hell. And I have to do all of it all over again. No! Bloody hell. How did they mess it so much? I don't know. dad was such a mess. Lost it all. I'll finish the race. I'll be third. Still, I need that experience points and cash. But again, we can definitely see that they slow down as soon as I'm behind them. Such a stupid mechanism. Hate it. Don't have I could try to No, I cannot mess him up, I can only mess up myself. Whoa, what happened there? What a mess. What a mess. Okay, I'm not driving that anymore, that car. It's just not fast enough on the straight. I need something faster. I don't want to use what can compete with LaFerrari on straights. Let's think about this. Actually, I thought that car will be capable of that. And probably if I was driving on puddles, would be much easier. But I don't want to do that. So, I don't have a huge choice, that a 40 maybe. Or I could just take Italia. I want a 40. I want to try with a 40. Just too good, that car, to not to try to drive it. Okay, I have it in N500, and that's where I want to keep it, that's where I want to keep it. Let's see how that drives in wet. Traffic jam here, whoa, whoa, whoa. Yeah, that was a traffic jam. Whoa, he bounced me back. What a guy. He was like, nope, you shall not pass. And that's LaFerrari on straight, so I'm still losing greatly on straight, but that's expected. And my max, my top speed is very similar, I think. Well, I'm a bit faster in the 40 than I was in the GTO. Okay, so I'm first. So I achieved the first place similar as with GTO by the second lap, but then they accelerated. And they were able to keep up with me. And yes, the gap is going down really quickly. It has to be LaFerrari behind me. Fast, I didn't see it coming. I'm in exactly the same situation as I was with GTO. And I'm missing gearing, which is definitely not helping. Two more laps. stopping in time. Try second gear now instead of the first one on some previous tries, previous laps. Well, at least I didn't mess up gearing now. And having 3.6 seconds at one point advantage over the second car. If I had that on the last lap, that's probably a win. That's the finish line, so that helps all of the down to 0.6, and then he breezes through. Braking is so dangerous. He starts braking while he's still on the right-hand side, and he's changing the line to the left-hand side. I'm braking later than he, but I have to then try to avoid him crossing through the whole of the road. It's crazy. The thing I don't understand is how LaFerrari, the car which always struggles when I drive it in every single race, on every single corner, it slides like crazy, how is it doing so well in those conditions? I understand the straights, yes, of course, that's just pure power, but I'm talking specifically about cornering. Suddenly he's able to keep up with me. And I gain a little bit at that stage. I'll try the first gear this time. That's the final lap. If I mess it up here, it's over. .1 seconds. That should be more than enough to win this time. Finally. Yeah, that's definitely going for me now. Never again that particular race. Horrible, horrible experience. F40 versus LaFerrari. I'm really surprised this other LaFerraris were not closer. Okay, so that's done. That was done, and I think the whole of the Ferrari La Festa has been completed now. Yeah,